Myself, Sweety Kashyap from the Adya College of Engineering and IT. Today, we are going to discuss about the topic Speed Control of DC Motor Using the Chopper Part 2. In Part 2, we discuss about the regenerative braking control method for speed control of DC motor. First of all, what is the regenerative braking control method? In this method, the motor acts as a generator and the kinetic energy of the motor connected is load is returned to the supply. This results in overall energy saving, which is the most welcome feature in transporting system requiring frequent stop. So this method is used for battery operated vehicle. This method used for separately excited DC motor speed control. In regenerative braking control method, the kinetic energy of motor is converted into the electrical energy and returned to the supply. Now, this is the circuit diagram of separately excited DC motor regenerative braking control method. As you see in this diagram, there is this R, A, L, A and E. This is the armature circuit. CH is the chopper, D is the diode, and this VF, this part is the field windings, which is separately provide supply from the armature supply. It means in the separately excited DC motor, both field and armature winding operate on different power supplies. Now let us discuss about the working of this control method. In this method, when chopper is on, it means when chopper is on, then current will be flow from this direction to armature and armature current flow back to the chopper. Due to this reason, that is the short circuit, so the terminal voltage, and we can say output voltage, is equal to zero. And when chopper is off, then the inductor of armature windings release their energy, and this, due to this energy, current IA, that is the armature current, flow in the diode and forcefully on the diode, and due to this source current flow in this direction, and this direction is reversed in this circuit. So when we draw the quadrant diagram of this motor, this operate in the second quadrant, because output voltage in this case when chopper is off, then output voltage, that is the terminal voltage, is equal to input voltage, but the current direction is reverse. Due to this, the hatch diagram of the separately excited DC motor is draw in the second quadrant. And in other words, we can say that in this method, the and current is flow from load to source. Okay. Now let us discuss about the waveforms. You can see here, that is the IA, that is the armature current. Armature current is maintained constant in all over the operation. VT is the terminal voltage, and it is also noted as output voltage. There is the time T on and T off. T on time when the chopper is on, and T off time when chopper is off. We already discussed that when chopper is on, then the output voltage is zero. And when chopper is off, then output voltage is equal to source voltage. Now IS is the source current. Source current is only flow when the armature inductance release their energy in the direction towards the supply voltage. That's why the in the T1 time period this current value is zero, and T off time period this value is equal to IS amplitude. It is the armature equal to armature current amplitude. Now IT is the terminal voltage, terminal current. That terminal current is flow during the T on time period when chopper is on, and when chopper is off, this current is zero. Here this period T on time period is equal to alpha T, and T off time period is equal to 1 minus alpha T, and total time period is equal to T, that is the chopping period. Now when we apply the KVL on this particular circuit, then we find the average output voltage across the chopper, that is the output voltage. Output voltage is only calculate in the T off time period. That's why T off upon T into the Vs is equal to 1 minus alpha Vs. This voltage is derived according to the step up chopper. Then power generated by the motor is equal to terminal voltage into the armature current. Then we put this value of Vt in this equations, then we find 1 minus alpha Vs Ra, and we multiply with Ra because there is the this current is due to the armature resistance. Okay, then motor EMF generated, that is equal to Ea, that is the Km dot omega m, and is equal to Vt plus IaRa. When we put the Vt value, that is equal to 1 minus alpha Vs, and motor speed during the regenerative braking method, we simplify this equations and we find speed of regenerative braking control method. In regenerative braking control method, how we find the maximum and minimum value of speed of motor? Then we put two situations, that is the chopper is on, when chopper is off. When chopper is on, then this is the KVL when we apply on the armature circuit, that is equal to zero, and we simplify that, we find out that the chopper on inductor store energy and current right to be must positive. And Li di by dt is current rise, so that is must be positive. That's why Ea minus Ira should be greater than equal to zero. In the another side, when chopper is off, that is we apply the same process, but in the when chopper is off, then terminal voltage is equal to source voltage, that we put there the Vs, and we further simplify that, and this time inductor release their energy in reverse direction, that's why it must be negative, and we simplified that equation, we find that Ea minus Ra IaRa is should be greater than equal to Vs, and we combine both the equations of chopper on and chopper off, then controlling power, we find that Ea minus IRa should be greater than equal to zero and greater than equal to Vs. When we apply this situation in the find out the braking speed for minimum and maximum, we simplify further Ea minus IRa is equal to zero, and we put the value of Ea is equal to Km omega m. Omega m is replaced by omega minimum, and we simplify, then we find the minimum braking speed, and for maximum braking speed, then we simplify this equation by this way, and we find the maximum value. So by this simplification, we find the regenerative braking control effective only when motor speed less than 2 omega max and more than the omega minimum. So by this way, we can control the speed of DC motor.